Hi viewers, welcome to BSP Voice. Of course, we have a series of guests. We are taking right great alumni from Viraj Institute of Technology. Of course, the people who are there really moving different countries and different places, higher positions. Among them, we have today Toshna. Toshna is one of the simplest and modest personalities of biomedical engineering. Of course, people choose software engineering, electronics, and electrical like. But here we have Toshna, who has chosen her path from different ways, different courses. But thing is here, even after finishing her BTech in biomedical engineering also, she could not turn her way. Just she moved forward in the same biomedical engineering, where she reached now in Germany. She is doing her master thesis there. And biomedical engineering as biomedical engineering student at Gandhi Hospital, and as a trainee she was a trainee at Gandhi Hospital, and then intern at the National Institute of Empowerment of Person with Intellectual Disabilities. She was an intern also where she was there in India, and education and training here, MSc biomedical engineering, and then BTech from Viraj Institute of Technology, Biomedical Engineering. And then you can see that Karnataka Board of Pre-University Education, where she finished her pre-education intermediate course, Indian Certificate of Secondary Education, ICSE syllabus. So we can see the profile is really great. At the same time, best project awardee also. So we can see when we see the profile of one person, the strengths of the persons are stronger. So the competition is very easier for them. So here Toshna also has very good profile, as she was selected as the best project awardee, third place, and qualified the finalist also IIT Mumbai, and participated and presented a working model of patient monitoring where she went for Technofest in 2016, and then she learned from the different institutions national institutions Mumbai. And then digital skills also, programming and processing skills, MATLAB, Java, computerization, fluid dynamics, and many of programming language, Python, and Fiji image, and language skills. She is a Sindhi. People are unable to speak even Telugu today. She knows Sindhi, Hindi, at the same time English, Telugu, and German too. She learned German too. So that her goal was there itself. So she set the goal before joining BTech, so that she learned German also, and at last she reached German. That's what we understand. Whenever we think seriously about anything, definitely we reach the place. So today our Toshna is going to say that, and her passion to learn German, and as she learned German, she reached Germany and doing her complete MS. She's going to complete her MS. So let us listen to her in her words, how she is doing all the things from her beginning of life to now. Welcome, Toshna, to BSP Voice. Hey. Voice with Bitla.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for having me.
Welcome. You're welcome.
So I just heard a lot of good things about me.
Oh, thank you.
But that's not all it is. I did my schooling in Hyderabad, and I finished my 10th in St. Anne's. Secunderabad. Then I moved to.
Are you from St. Anne's? Your St. Anne's?
Yeah, I'm from.
Oh, very good.
Yeah, I'm from St. Anne's.
Mm, high school. Schooling completed St. Anne's.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Oh.
Yeah. And then I moved to Bangalore for 2 years, and I did my 11th and 12th over there. And I had taken all the subjects. In Hyderabad, people usually take 3 subjects, right? It's either MPC or BIPC. And I had taken all the 4. So I had MBIPC with 2 languages. And because that's the system in Karnataka, you have to take 4 subjects. So I did that, and I still did not know what I wanted to be. I did not have... Yeah, because, a lot of people started going for coaching around me, from 8th standard, they went to IIT coaching and stuff like that. And I did not know what I wanted to do or what I wanted to be. So by the end of 12th, when you're supposed to know which kind of engineering you're supposed to join or if you want to go for medicine, I was still confused because I hadn't really given it much thought, because whenever I started to think about it, I was just confused.
Yeah.
The only interest I had was science. Science interested me right from when I was a kid. Science and English literature, but science was something I wanted to pursue. So I did not know what I wanted to do or what I wanted to be. And every time I thought about it, I just ended up more confused. So I decided I'd go for engineering because, well, medicine costed a lot in India, you know. So I was, and I was moving back to Hyderabad too. So I thought that, okay, I'll pursue engineering. And then I ended up writing the JE exam and all the other MCET exam and all the other exams that you can find. I wrote all of them with little or no preparation. And I won't say that I scored really bad marks or I scored really good marks, because today when I look back, I realize that it never mattered. My marks were just a number and my rank was just a number and it really didn't matter. So then I wanted to go for civil engineering, you know, right after you've written MCET and you get your rank, and then you have the whole period between you getting your rank and the college being assigned to you. You have the period where you have to fill in the, I forgot what it's called, but you have to fill the choices or your priorities that you want this college and this engineering and this college. And yeah, the priority form or something. And I filled up civil engineering. And a lot of y'all might laugh at me because I did not know what civil engineers did. I passed out 12th and I did not know what civil engineers did, but I wanted to be one. And my mom was highly shocked. My mom was like, your interest is biology. Why are you running behind civil engineering? Do you even know what they do? She just sat me down and asked me this. What do they do? I was like, I don't know. That guy comes in the Ultratech ad, you know, with the yellow hat, yellow safety hat. And I want to be that because that seems like a good career. She's like, your interest is biology. Like, you love reading about it. Because I was the kind of kid who read a lot. My best friends were books. You could leave me alone with TV and books and I would choose books any day.
Actually, students choose TV only than the books, but you choose the books than the TV. That's what you're different from. You are out of the crowd.
It's not that I didn't watch TV. It was just that I loved knowing things. I don't like, you know, knowing things because it's going to help me in an exam. I like knowing things because I just like knowing things. That's it. There's no other reason for it. So I used to read a lot of books, and I used to, like, on one side I used to read a lot of novels, but on the other hand, when I wanted to, I used to read a lot of science-based books, you know, those fact books that you get. I used to read those a lot. So then my mom was like, I've seen you grow up reading those books, you know, where they talk about the human body and stuff like that in great detail, and now you're telling me you want to build and now you're telling me that you want to build buildings and it doesn't match, like, where you've shown interest and what you want to pursue, they don't really match. And if you do pursue civil engineering, you're going to break all the buildings that you build. He really told me that.
Unless you have intensity, it's not possible.
I mean, she just told me that you might be, you might build buildings, but they're not going to last because you have no interest in them. So that made sense to me, coming from my mom especially, because she's a teacher as well. So it made a lot of sense to me that, you know, she's telling me this. Let me just think about it. So I took a step back. The first thing I Googled was, is there biology in engineering? Right after I spoke to my mom, I searched this. And then I came to know that there were branches of engineering like, you know, biotechnology and biomedical, bioengineering and biomimetics. extent.
Yes, yes.
There are a lot of
many sub branches.
Yeah, there are many sub branches, and I then filtered which of them are available near to me. And then I came to know that there's biomedical engineering that interests me more than biotechnology, because I like human anatomy more. So I went in this direction. And then I came to know that there were only two colleges offering biomedical in Hyderabad, which is OU and BVRIT.
Yeah.
So the next week, I came down to BVRIT. I told them that I would like an admission here. And then they gave me one. So I was here. And when I joined engineering, I knew that I wanted to go for master's. I was always very sure of it. Within my first semester, I knew that I wanted.
Hello. Hello. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Tell me.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
Hmm.
So, yeah, as you can see, I'm doing my master's in biomedical engineering today. I obviously did not pursue genetic engineering, which I'm okay with, because as I went through my engineering and I learned more subjects, because your first year is mainly, you just learn a lot of common subjects. There's nothing in-depth taught about your engineering to you.
Yes.
So when I came to my second year, I learned about EEG and the brain and stuff like that. And I got to know that, okay, so this is something I'm interested in. This is something I could do. Then I started searching if I can pursue neuroscience further. And I did apply to, like, I started filtering out colleges where I could study neuroscience, being a biomedical engineering student, because that's not really accepted around the world. Because neuroscience is a pure sciences course, while biomedical engineering is engineering, so they don't really match.
Neuroscience belongs to the medicine.
It belongs to neurology.
It belongs to medicine. Yes.
Yeah, I wanted to do that, but then I did apply to a few courses in Germany. I got rejected by all of them, giving me the same reason that you're from engineering background, you cannot do this. So I was like, okay, fine, I cannot do this, but I can still do biomedical engineering because I'm a trained biomedical engineer.
Yeah.
So then I applied, but then the thing was, coming to Germany also wasn't something that was my first choice. I wanted to go to US initially. I had even decided the college, the course, the dorm, everything was, I had decided everything in my mind.
Yes.
Not just planned, decided that this is something I will do. This is where I study. This is where I live.
Yeah.
And
Predetermined mind.
Yeah, I had decided everything. Irrespective of the answer I was going to get from the university, everything from my end was decided that this is something I want to do. But then I took a step back again and I looked at the expenses, because expenses played a major role in deciding where I wanted to study.
Yes.
I could take an educational loan. Yeah. But do I really want to start my career with a huge loan on my head already?
It is definitely necessary. Yeah.
Yeah, because I don't want to burden my parents. Yeah. And if I'm taking an educational loan, I have to pay it at the end of the day.
Yeah, sure.
So do I really want to spend my money later on when I'm earning, paying back a loan, or do I want to actually use that money to live a proper life, was the question I had in my mind. So then I started searching for more options where I could study. I made a list of pros and cons for many countries like US, Canada, Switzerland, Australia, New Zealand. And then I landed on Germany because a lot of my classmates were already discussing about Germany. And even though they were discussing it, I was still, you know, going through other countries like US and Canada. I was still debating those with myself.
Yeah, actually, BME has BME has the best option in Germany itself.
In Germany, So then I thought about it, like, you know, maybe about it. So they might be talking about it for a reason, right? Like they are, like they obviously know what they're talking about. So I gave it a thought as well, and then I figured out what I would need to study in Germany, like. What are the qualities, or what are the, I don't know, what's supposed to be in me to study here? Like, you know, what would they require of
requirements,
me?
Requirements, yes.
People over here, or the university over here.
How to be ease.
Yeah.
Ease.
And the first thing, or most probably, like, how to not get rejected by a university in Germany. Like, instead of how to get accepted by a university in Germany,
instead of that,
I made myself how to not get rejected by a university in Germany, because easier option.
You have
like
complete clear idea, clear mindset. You have complete clear mindset, indeed.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. So, I just started making my profile in such a way that I don't get rejected by any university, because I had already gotten rejected by a few neuroscience university, right? So I didn't want the same to happen for BME. So I knew that I had to learn German first of all. My uni does not require me to learn German, but I learned German because if I'm living in Germany, I better know the language. That's the least I can do.
It's true.
Because if country is letting me live here and study here, the least I can do is learn their language.
Yes.
Because, like, as a form of respect and also to ease my life. Because you can't expect somebody to just move their entire life and not know the language. I'm going to fall in trouble later on if I don't know the language.
Yes, yes.
It's not that nobody talks in English here, but I think it's always better to know the language where you're where you are. So then I learned German. I started learning German a year before I came. I think in fourth year. Yeah. I spent my entire fourth year learning German on the weekends. And 5 days a week I used to go to college. So I had a pretty hectic life for 1 year. But it was fun. Like I always had something to do. I wasn't idle ever.
Okay.
Yeah, and so the first thing I did was learn German. Second thing was I had to write my IELTS and get a good score. So in Germany, they require a pretty low score from IELTS compared to US and Canada. Like some universities require 5.5 and some of them require a 6.5. It's nothing more than that.
Yes, yes.
Even the best university requires you to have 6.5, nothing more than that.
Yes, score.
So when I wrote my IELTS, I got an 8, which was perfect. I didn't have to worry about IELTS anymore. It was much better than what the university was asking me. Then it was the marks and everything. And to be honest, I was a pretty average student in college. I did not aim to be the topper. Neither did I want to be one. I did not see the point in remembering stuff and then writing them down. I rather like to understand the concept and reproduce how much ever I have understood. I don't like to remember things. So it didn't matter to me that I was in the topper and I didn't get a 10 point or a 9 point or something. I had a pretty decent score, got me into a university. So that I wasn't worried about either. I'm still the same. I don't care about marks. As long as I'm understanding the subject and I'm doing my exam, that's enough.
Yes. Yeah. Hello. Hello. Toshna. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Yeah.
Yeah, so why is this happening?
Yeah, it's acting. There's net problem with you, it seems. Okay.
With me?
Yeah.
I'm connected on my Wi-Fi.
It's okay. Come on, continue.
Yeah, so I did not sit and say that, oh my God, I wanted to do neuroscience. Why am I not doing neuroscience and all that? Because my main point was, if I have to do neuroscience, I can do it later in life also. Like, I can find a way to do it. Because neuroscience, I wanted to do it as a branch of biomedical engineering. I didn't want to pursue pure neuroscience anyway. So I just took up internships. Anything that came in my way, I took it up. Any certificate that I could get, I took it up. Because at the end of the day, it was just adding to my profile. Because what you think is your passion is a feeling. A passion at the end of the day is just an emotion. But you doing that work is going to drive you towards your passion. So anything that comes your way, just take it. And I believe in that just take it. You might not reach where you want to reach. You might reach someplace better. But if you don't start anywhere, you're just going to be stuck there. Because in the illusion of following your passion, you're just going to be stuck there, and that's just pointless. Instead, you can just take up things you want that are coming in your way. Just take them up, try them out. If you're still not able to do it, then reject them. That's always an option to leave things later on. But if you reject them before you even have tried them or before you've even started them, then you've missed out on the opportunity to ever decide whether you really wanted them or not. And yeah, then I took up internships, got certificates, applied, got accepted by a lot of universities for biomedical engineering. And then I chose this one. I'm studying at FA Aachen. And I'm pretty happy to be studying here.
What's the university name?
And
What's the university name?
Fachhochschule Aachen, it translates to Aachen University of Applied Sciences.
Halkin.
Aachen.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, Aachen University of Applied Sciences. And yeah, and I'm happy to be studying here. In about a year, I'll be completing my master's. It's been a year since I came, and in about a year, I'll be completing my master's as well. I'm doing my master thesis right now, and I'm very happy to be doing it at a very reputed place. Which again, I didn't plan for, but it is in my way, and I took it up because when I started my master's, I was clueless. I did not know how to study here, honestly, because the way you study in India and the way you're supposed to study here is a big difference. And no matter how good of a student you are, or no matter how bad of a student you are, you're gonna see the difference. And I was scared. I was scared to write my exams. And so I didn't write them. I just didn't write my exams. I studied for six subjects and I didn't write three of them. So now when I look back and I see, I'm like, I should have just written it. Like, I would have gotten some grade, any grade. But the fact that I would have written it would have given me some experience. Which is why I'm saying anything that comes your way, just take it. Later on, you can reject it or later on, you can dispose it of. But just take it. And disposing might not be something you would want to do later on because as you keep going through things, you're going to learn. You're going to learn how to navigate through those things. You're going to develop the skills to be able to do them. But if you don't start them, those skills are not going to come to you. Skills are not something you're born with. Skills are something you develop. And this is something I've learned in this 1 year that I've been here. Because I did not think that I would be somebody who would get scared of studying, because I loved knowing things and I always wanted to study, so there was nothing wrong with me being here. But yet when it came down to it, I was damn scared of everything that was around me. I never felt that I was in a competition, like the mindset that people usually have in India, that you're competing with your classmates at all times. I never felt like I was in a competition.
No, no. unique personalities cannot feel that they are competing. Hello? Yes.
Yeah. So, all in all, what I want to say is that just get to know what it is you want to do. Make a plan and follow through your plan. Have the courage to follow through your plan no matter what. A lot of people are not going to believe in you, and that's okay. They don't have to. As long as your parents are going to believe in you, or if there is one person that's believing in you, and that's your friend, it's okay. Just have a person who believes in you. And even if you don't have a friend who believes in you or your parents, just be there for yourself to believe in you, because you're going to have to be your best friend most of the time. You have to know yourself. And if you don't know who you are, just get to know what you are not. That's easier. Get to know what you're not comfortable with. Get to know what you are not going to be like, or get to know what are the qualities you want to have, or what are the qualities you don't want to have. Either way, just have the courage to follow through the plan that you make. And your plans might not always go the way you've thought that they're going to go. And that's okay, because they might not go the way you want them to go, but they'll always go through because you've worked hard. You've done your work. And there are just some things you can't control. So the part that you can control is your work. Just do your work sincerely. And as long as you're sincere with your work, there's nothing in the world that's going to stop you from reaching where you're supposed to reach. That's it. Just follow through your plans and have the courage to follow through your plans.
Yeah. Overall, you say that the passion to reach any place, and right, listen to your heart and follow it properly. With the constructive right way of life, taking the good advices from the elders and known people. So that definitely...
Yeah, and just one more thing. Don't get sucked into just making your life all about work. Develop hobbies. Develop, you know, other things rather than your work, your career. Because you might end up working at a company, but there should be something more to it than, you know, more to you than just... You know, that you work at so-and-so company or you own so-and-so company. You could be an entrepreneur too. I'm not denying.
Yeah.
But develop as many hobbies as you can, or learn something to do just for fun.
Yes.
Because that's needed to, you know, carry, you know, doing your best at work. That's needed. You need a creative element in your life. Read as much as you can. Or if you're not a reader, listen to podcasts. Learn every single day. There are things that you can learn. So just learn as much as you can. Anything. Yeah. You might be too old to be the best at like ballet and stuff like that, but you're never too old to learn those things.
Yeah, learn to be fun, not to be serious. Yeah. When the people feel it's fun, it's easy to learn.
Yeah, and isn't it like, you know, when you do something that tickles your fun element, and when you go back to work after that, you're more refreshed because you're more, your brain works better. You've given yourself to rest, and that's important. So just don't get sucked into working and working and working. I know college and everything is important. I'm not saying it's not, but other things are important too. Your family is important to give them time. Listen to your parents, talk to them, talk to your siblings if you have any. Make time for your friends, meet them. But don't spend all your time on those things. You have to schedule yourself.
Okay. Yeah, very good. So thank you so much, Toshna. It's really
great
talk to you. Definitely, the points what you discussed will benefit the students and the youth tomorrow who are getting into the undergraduate course of BME or any other courses and who would like to come to Germany and join other MS courses also. Thank you so much for being with PSP Voice. All the best for your all the endeavors, whatever you feel. Definitely you settle in your life at the best position. Thank you so much for being with me.
Thank you, sir.